So good morning all. In the last class we were discussing on the strain energy due to axial stress or normal stress, and we were discussing on some few problems on relating this. Now next I'll explain the strain energy due to shear stress. What happens if the strain energy, if a shear stress is happening? So we look that. Okay, so from here, this diagram, you have a block ABCD, say this rectangular block, and a shear stress is happening due to a load, shear force P. Okay, shear stress is tau, and this length is L, and due to this shear stress, a small deformation of DL in an angle phi is happening. Okay, so here you consider a square of length L, as I have explained it. The side DC is experiencing a shear force P applied tangentially on DC. Okay, phi is the deformed angle. So, okay, A is the area of its side, G is the modulus of rigidity of the material. Right, now we know that shear stress is shear force by area. So shear stress here is shear force is P, and by area P is equal to tau A, which is equal to area is L square, since this is a square. Okay, now from triangle AD D' tan phi is equal to DD' by AD, which is nothing but DL by L, which is nothing but the shear strain. So DL is phi into L. Okay, now work done is force into distance, right? And that we already found it as 1 by 2 P into DL for gradually applied load, which is nothing but the strain energy. So 1 by 2 into P is nothing but tau L square into DL is phi into L, right? So U is equal to 1 by 2 phi tau L cube. So from Hooke's law, shear stress by shear strain is rigidity modulus. G is equal to tau by phi. Instead of phi, we'll substitute this equation, tau by G. Then the equation becomes U is equal to tau square by 2G into L cube. L cube is nothing but the volume of the cube. So tau square by 2G into V. So this is the strain energy due to the action of a shear force or shear stress. Now next thing, first we derived that of a normal stress, now shear stress, now due to bending, and after that we will be discussing on torsion. Okay, now what happens if pure bending of a beam happens? Okay, now you have a beam AB and of length L, and we consider a small portion of this, and its length is DL, its area is DA, the distance from this point to this section is X. Okay, now from bending equation we know that from mechanics of solids, we know that M by I is equal to sigma by Y is equal to E by R, right? So from here, sigma is equal to M by I into Y. Okay, we know that strain energy is sigma square by 2E into V. Substitute this value of sigma in this equation, right? So U is equal to M by I into Y the whole square into 1 by 2E into volume is nothing but this volume, dA into small length dL. This becomes like this. So for small area, you will integrate this one, okay, from 0 to L, you will get this value, right? So U is nothing but integral 0 to L M square by 2EI DL, or else you can write U is equal to M square L by 2EI. Better you study this formula, that will be useful for your operations, right? Okay, now what happens if there is a torsion in a beam? What happens if here we studied about bending and now torsion? Okay, That also will derive it from torsion equation T by J is equal to G theta by L equal to tau by R that we have already studied from our basics of prerequisite portion mechanics of solids. So shear stress is TR by J. Okay, where T is the torque, R is radius and J is polar moment of inertia. Right. Now we will consider a shaft which is having a torsion. J is the polar moment of inertia, T is the torque. Okay, now tau xy is TR by J. Strain energy equation tau square by 2G into V, that means sigma square. Here it will be tau square by 2E becomes G. Okay, or else just know this equation. Okay, tau square by 2G into V. Okay, due to shear stress, that equation is applied here and you integrate it, you will get instead of tau you give this value. Okay, this value. Okay, then you will get, while solving this one, you will get u is equal to integral u 0 to L t square by 2 gj dx, or t square L by, again it's better to study this formula for problems. Okay, now this a simple method called work energy method, and this method is applicable only if a single load acts on a beam. Okay, so use of strain energy deflection under a single load, this is very important, under a single load. So for a single load application, work energy method tells that for a bending case, if deflection y of under load, then u is equal to 1 by 2 p into y. For if there is only one load, the strain energy of that beam will be 1 by 2 p y. Similarly, if it is having a moment, then u is equal to 1 by 2 m theta. Theta is deflection in terms of angle of rotation. Maximum c. This is the maximum theta, right? And next, in case of a torsion, will be 1 by 2 t into phi. See, again, I will tell that this approach is possible only if member is subjected to a single load only. This method is called work energy method. Okay, so let us summarize the equations. Due to tensile force or an axial force, u is integral p square dx by 2 ea, and for due to shear force, it's, you just change this, instead of p here it's shear in case of shear force, and instead of g here it's e. Okay, that's the only difference, right? And due to moment, it's m square dx by 2 ei, instead of tau it's m, and instead of g here it's I. Similarly, instead of m here it's t, and instead of e here e g, and instead of I it's polar moment of inertia. Okay, and the first derivation we have done is general expression for strain energy in case of x, y and z stress and strains. It will be like this. Okay, so in the next class, we'll go for problems regarding all these four equations. Okay, thank you.